Good evening, YouTube. I just got back from Ottawa. I picked up from a girl who broke her breeding tank and was in a hurry to get rid of her electric blue crayfish that she's been breeding to feed to her pet Oscars, which is a very large cichlid. So these ones are just going to go straight into the tilapia tank to grow out. She said she put 52 in the bucket, but I'm counting more like 60. And then out of this batch, I want to save 3 males, one for each of the tanks in the living room, and 2 females each for the 2 large tanks. And I already have 1 female in the small tank. I took the lid off of this cooler, the hose that goes down into it for the air pump. There was a female hung on 4 inches from the top. When I took her off and turned her over, she was fully buried. She has probably 50 eggs on her swimmerettes. And I also got, I don't know, that looks like more than 16, but that's 16 guppies. I'm going to save a few in one of the aquariums in the house here, including that great big female. I'm gonna shoot for 2 females, there are 3 females, and a couple of males if I can manage that. And then the rest are gonna go out in my duckweed tank to eat any mosquito eggs and larvae that get laid in there. So my primary interest here is the largest of them. Now this is a female. Can you hand me a chopstick out of the drawer? This sexing method works for all of the Procambarus crayfish types. Right here at the base of the third walking legs, you can see 2 little round circles, and that's her gonopores, which is like her oviducts. So that's a female. I'm sexing largest to smallest. This is another female. Again, you can see on the third walking leg, the gonopores, the little circles. Grab them without actually hurting them. This as well is a female. Again, you can see the gonopores on the third walking legs. So we need 1 more female. And all the rest of the females will go out to. And this one again is a female. That's a female. I may want to. I may wind up having to go through the ones that I figured were too small to bother sexing to find a male. So we will. Move the guppies out of the way. Now, this one's a female as well. You can see she has eggs attached to her swimmerettes. You see that? But I don't want to put any of the smaller females in with the biggest tilapia, so this is another female. Another female with eggs. Another female. Another female with eggs. Another female with eggs. Another female with one egg. Another female with eggs. Another female. Another female with eggs. Another female. And another female. I'm going to throw these all back in here just because it's so much easier to. That's the one with the biggest cluster of eggs. I'm going to put that in the small aquarium right now. You just want to pause the camera. Now we need to look for males. That's a female. That's a female. That's a female. This was an awful lot easier in high school when they were pinned to a board and already dead. That's a female. it's a female. It's a female. That's a female. That's a female. Can't see the gonopores on that, but all of the swimmerettes at in the tail section point back, so that's a female with eggs. That I'm going to bet is a female because all the swimmerettes are pointing back. 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 I think that might be a male. Big hurry to get into the stove. Okay, that one's a male. All the swimmerettes are pointing back. How did that one go? Must have landed back in the bucket because it didn't land in there, it didn't land on the counter. All the swimmerettes are pointing back. swimmer. Eyes are pointing back. All the swimmer rats are pointing back. I don't know if you'll be able to see this. Where did I put my chopstick? The very first pair of swimmerettes right there are pointing forward. Right here and here, point forward up in between. And that is indicative of it being a male. All the swimmerettes are pointing back. Know what to think of that one, because the swimmerettes on one side are pointing forward and the swimmerettes on the other side are pointing back. Maybe a hermaphrodite. That one go. Must have gone in here because. Five left in there. All the swimmer rats are pointing back. First pair of swim rats is pointing forward. Swimmerettes is pointing forward. And the last one here is itty bitty. And feisty. All the swimmerettes are pointing back. So we are going to take all of these out and dump them into the aquaponics. I have couple of dozen 2-inch long pieces, or sorry, 3-inch long pieces of 2-inch PVC pipe. And 2 rolls of plastic snow fence about that big around to keep the tilapia well away from them. So we'll pause the camera and go out to the... Okay, so I have a piece of 4-inch ABS that is now sitting on top of the roll of snow fence. Tilapia are fundamentally vegetarian, so they should not bother the crayfish too much. I went into town the other day and came back with 12 ghost shrimp that I put up in here in the duckweed bed to help with debris cleanup in there. The crayfish will help with debris cleanup in here, and when they get to be full-size adults, we'll have a crayfish boil. Let's go back in the house. Okay, since all these males are so tiny, we're going to put them in the 5-gallon tank with the 2 really heavily buried females, because there's no other fish in there right now, and that's where we're going to put the guppies to breed. So if you want to come out to the living room. Out of the net, everybody's out of the net. So when you're sexing guppies, the first indicator is size. This is a female. She's way bigger than all the rest, and she has no color. This is, again, a female. Oh, no, it is a male. It's very hard to... The anal fin on the male has a stiff ray at the front that is male organ. This one has lots of color, which is how you know it's a male. It
most indicative feature. You see the ray of the anal fin there has, it's a large hollow tube. It is his manhood. Oh.